Hello, wonderful Pisces. Welcome back to the Lucky Tarot. Thank you so much for tuning in. I have for you another general love and relationship reading. This is intended for Sun, Moon, and Rising Pisces signs. It is intuitive, and feel free to reverse the roles as well, especially for cross-watchers. If these messages do resonate, please like, share, and subscribe. I would really appreciate that. But if they don't, please check your Venus, Jupiter, and Mercury signs for a more accurate reading. All right, so Pisces. Let's see what are the energies for you guys. We're going to get two cards, one for you, one for the other person involved, okay? Spirit, angels, universe, give us the energies for the sign of Pisces, Sun, Moon, Rising, in love and relationship, period of April 20th until the 30th. Okay, so we have TikTok for you, and the other person is regeneration. Wow, I'm getting that vibe wherein... Wow, I'm just, wonderful energy that I'm picking up. All right, so the vibe that I'm getting is that you finally have the opportunity with this person. If for a time you let things slip, okay, I'm trying to find the words, sorry, I'm excited because of the vibe that I'm picking up for you, Pisces. What seemed to be in a dormant phase for far too long, or something that you thought is already over, it's like time is opening an opportunity for you. Whatever it is, it could be a work situation, it could be a relationship that you have been thinking for a while now, but something in the air, in the universe, orchestrating this timing, it's a divine timing, TikTok, for this to take place, for this to manifest. Regeneration, as we all know, this is all about giving life to something that we thought was dead. It's rekindling even relationships, fixing what we thought is already broken, okay? But it takes a while for this to manifest. But with TikTok, now you have the opportunity to revisit something or to do things all over again. But of course, in a different light, in a different time, okay? So, wow, amazing. It could be a long-term relationship and you guys have ended this in the past, but now it could be reconciliation. Or it could be that you've been waiting for far too long for a news to favor what you've been asking for the universe to happen in your career, in your home, in your money, or even in yourself. And now it's like the time has come. The time has really come for this to grow, for this to manifest for you. Beautiful, beautiful energy. Later on, I'm going to read to you what these oracle cards are in the booklet, because this one provides a more detailed information. We're going to check in next with your main energies. Wow, amazing, Pisces. I can't wait to see the main energies, and I'm using the Tarot Mucha. Already pre-shuffled your cards. I can't wait to see the energies. See, even my energy, I'm picking up your energy, Pisces. There's excitement. There's fun. All right. Whoa. You have the World card instantly. Instantly, I sense that this is a cycle that's going to start again from something that has ended, a chapter that you thought is over. Okay. But now it's like it's starting, regenerating. Something in the background tells me this relationship or this opportunity is brewing in divine timing for you, okay? Because now you have learned the lesson, you or this person that you're connecting with, you both have already learned the lesson. It takes lessons to really change people, transform people to become better for each other. And even though there are couples, broken relationships that are not meant to be reconciled, there are, in fact, successful reconciliations in our lifetime. And it's all about divine timing. I feel like the chemistry and the attraction and the love never actually died. It's just that the circumstances have drifted you two apart. But again, the time has come for this to have a proper continuation, or even just communicating once again, okay? I feel like this person could be away from you, and maybe that's the reason why you guys have ended this in the past, and this was long ago, okay? I could even be talking to someone you knew in your childhood. So it differs from one Pisces to another. All right, more cards. Yep, we have the Eight of Cups, and we have the Moon card. Interesting. the other person. Gonna get all the cards out first. So for cross watchers, feel free to reverse the energies. We are dealing with energies. It is always fluid. Okay. Bottom of the deck, we have the King of Cups. Beautiful. I'm gonna get first the cards from the bottom of the deck just so that we have a general theme on your reading. So King of Cups, well, this is definitely your suit, Pisces. You're coming across as the King of Cups. It doesn't matter if it's a male or female. We all have those kind of energies. But this period of April, I see that you are somewhat celebrating something new here. Something really you're passionate about, a relationship maybe, because something is coming to life once again. This talks about being inspired, okay, and following what the spirit is calling you. If it's a relationship, you feel like it's worth celebrating, it's worth putting yourself into that situation, because there's something here. There's something here that is worth holding on to, all right? If for a time you've been distant, Pisces, because the King of Cups can also come across as someone who keeps their love in a distance. This person is on an island by himself. So I feel like it could have been your energy in the past where you've been loving this person from a distance. Again, there's that element of geographical distance. Maybe you guys live in different places, different races, whatever the situation is, but you've been loving this person. And you could also be dealing with a water sign, so this can also be their energy. You both are still feeling passionate about one another, even in distance, okay? So look at that. We have the Eight of Wands. Wow. It's like things are finally going to move forward. You're going to hear a news, all right, about this person. Again, the timing. The time has come for things to start moving, for this to start, you know, happening. A regeneration of the connection. And since this is a love relationship, if you're single, then I feel like you're going to communicate with someone, could be a water sign, Cancer, Scorpio, Pisces, through social media. You're going to hear from this person. It could be someone that you look up to as a mentor, someone who also is quite like a father figure, all right, someone who cares about your welfare. They are someone also very artistic, very articulate with words. They express their emotions freely. But in the since Eight of Wands is also a card of communicating via social media because of distance, then I feel like there's going to be open lines of communication once again. Something is going to resume most definitely, okay? But I feel like in the past, and I'm getting this Nine of Pentacles energy, you've been single. So maybe I'm talking to Pisces that are single, and you may not have heard from this person for a long time, or that you've isolated yourself. Okay, you focused on money, you focused on your career, you focused on everything that you've worked hard for. And I see that you're very blessed, you're very abundant, and you have this strong independent energy. You don't need anyone to feel you, okay? So safe to say you are content, you're satisfied, but then this is something unexpected, the Eight of Wands. It's like something started, you or this person started something again, set things in motion, and communication is gonna start to resume. Okay, interesting, really interesting energies. So back with your main energies, the World card, yeah, I see that as a card of distance, migration, different races, but I also see that you had a chapter in the past that has ended and has closed, thinking that, well, it was done and over with. But for some reason, there are things that we cannot explain, of course. That is how the universe works sometimes, and that is why the Moon card is here. So maybe you're wondering, why the heck am I here in this situation once again? Or this could be the other person thinking, well, there are signs being presented, but I want to know why this have to resurface once again. And it's all about the timing. There are situations we don't really have the clear answers. The Moon card represents mystery. It represents a feeling of uncertainty, but definitely in time it's going to be made revealed to you. Something is going to make sense. Again, there's that element of time. Okay, so this time pay close attention to your intuition, Pisces. I know that you guys are very intuitive people, but If you let too much fears get the best of you, you may just block what your intuition is telling you. So if you've been dreaming about signs, you've been seeing signs all around you, take a hold of that, you know, and listen to what your spirit guides have been telling you, because that will reveal the answers that you seek. Okay, it's all about divine timing. So I did mention Eight of Cups, and this is like you walking away from that situation in the past, okay? And I'm picking up a past energy because, well, it could have been, like I mentioned, a long-term relationship. It is the Eight of Cups. It took a while for you guys to build this relationship solidly. You know, it takes a while for Eight of Cups to accumulate. So walking away from that situation was not easy. Okay, it was difficult. It brought a lot of heartache, a lot of maybe mixed emotions. Maybe you could still feel some mixed emotions, okay? And I'm seeing here in the cards, you may still be thinking about whether or not you're going to walk away from the situation again, because you cannot understand what is the meaning, what is the purpose as to why things are regenerating. But you see, with the Moon card, not everything is what it seems. It may seem to you that this is something that is not meant to happen. Well, you will be surprised, Pisces, that this person is meant to cross your path once again. Could be for lessons, could be for closure, or could be for reconciliation. That is also a possibility, okay? So I'm seeing a lot of past energies, and that's I'm reading intuitively over here, Pisces. So the other person has Eight of Swords. In the period that you both have not communicated, this person thought about you a lot. They have you on their mind constantly. They would go back in the past and think about the relationship. But this could also be subconsciously. They weren't able to move forward from the relationship they had with you. So you see two eights are here. So almost feels like you both move in different directions already. You moved in towards your career, maybe. This other person also tried to move places. If you guys, you know, separated and you just suddenly decide to go in different paths. And I feel like during that time, this person had some mental fears, okay? They may have feared the ending. They may have feared, you know, that they still want to be with you, but they can't do anything about it or to take that breakup back because it already happened. And I sense that kind of energy for them. So Five of Swords energy, and I would see why you can still consider walking away now. Remember I said Moon card, there's just a lot of uncertainty with how you feel. You want to see where it goes, but at the same time, you're not so sure whether or not it is enough to make this work, okay? And I would understand why. But at the end of the day, it's your decision to make, Pisces. But all I can say is that with the Five of Swords, they have the same fears as you do. They don't want to start things or an argument once again. They don't want to start a fight that they can't win, if that makes sense. So I feel like maybe you're trying to decide on walking away because you fear that this person hasn't changed or the circumstances will be back from how they were in the past. But rest assured with regeneration and TikTok, time has served you lessons, all right? Time has served you lessons. And it could be that this person is only leaning on towards the negative because they fear that, you know, this regeneration wouldn't take place. So the negative is being highlighted. And so it discourages them to have the ability to walk towards you and actually ask for a reconciliation. And so maybe you take their silence as a sign that they're not really serious about the situation, or they're giving you security about why this had to happen again. So again, the two of you are resurfacing in this situation, but both of you have doubts. So that is what the Moon card is actually. It's mystery, it's uncertainty, it's emotional turmoil, but things are not what they truly seem. So you need to listen to your intuition. Even if this person appears like they can't be trusted, you have to go deeper and find out for yourself if that situation is what you think it is. But most often than not, these are just mental fears that we project. And oftentimes people lash out, people walk away because of things that they cannot process, that they cannot understand, or that people give up easily because they feel like there's no other situation out, okay? I have here the Two of Pentacles. So the other person is still holding on to the relationship, okay? And I feel like they also focus on money. They've also focused on their career. They focus on what they can balance in their life when the two of you were not really communicating. Okay? So the difference here is that you had the Nine of Pentacles. The person you're dealing with had some time juggling situations in their life. Maybe that's the reason why they weren't truly able to be a partner for you in the past, because they've been so used to juggling situations. But sadly, they weren't able to commit to you at that time, and hence you walked away from that situation. And that's what I truly see. Okay, so I'm going to clarify a bit here because I want to get more information. Pisces, it is an interesting story, and I'm contemplating whether or not I'm going to make like an extended reading, but maybe for next time, okay? So, let's see. What is the World card? Why is the World card here? Clarify the World card, please. This one. Yeah, this is definitely someone you already met in the past, okay? And so, wow. Six of Cups with Nine of Cups. You both genuinely feel happiness in the past. There has been a wonderful connection in the past. This is someone who was kind to you, all right, in the beginning. It could also be a soulmate. You miss each other. That's what I see. And it's like you're wishing for another chance to go back to the past. Or this could be the person that you are dealing with. And again, TikTok. So maybe if this person is not going to reach out to you by the end of April, then best believe it's going to happen soon, because energies are always fluid. This person is desiring to reconnect with you and bring the same kind of energy that you both had in the past or in the beginning. So again, it's only a matter of time. And so look at that. They did regret what they've done. They regretted losing you. Or this could also be your energy where you're still afraid to open up to this person for fear of, again, being disappointed and being left out in the cold, whatever situation it was that has hurt you with this person, okay? So yes, this person is wishing upon a star. They're still thinking about you. They're still trying to manifest the connection, because it was rare, okay? It was a rare connection that they only have experience with you. So pay attention to the signs. This could be something that will resurface in time. Maybe the Moon card is telling, maybe you thought it was over, but it's really not, okay? Maybe it's really not. Yep. Wow. This is a card of waiting. As you all know, Three of Wands, it is a sure success. Right now, it may seem like the story is just partially unfolding, right? But in time, wow. And we have the Ten of Pentacles and the Two of Wands. Awesome. Oh my gosh. Sooner or later, you're going to have to decide on your happy ever after. And I feel like you're going to choose love. You're going to choose happiness. But now, it's all about a waiting game. It's either you're waiting for this person to make a move or they're waiting to hear from you. Either way, there's the element of time, an element of waiting for the right divine timing for this to take place. But best believe, I don't feel like this story is over, because we have regeneration. It is just meant to take a pause. It is meant that you heal and the other person heals. And there's like a deeper path that you need to go through, and the person that you're dealing with as well, Pisces, because that's what the universe sees that you need in order to evolve, okay? That is the World card, evolution, lessons, enlightenment, and awareness. And that already take place and is about to take place in your journey, okay? So this is definitely going to happen. So keep your eye on this and your ear open on this opportunity, if that is something that you would consider. So this is your reading. To wrap things up, I'm going to read to you TikTok and regeneration, as said in the booklet, because I feel like this is something that you need to hear. I'm going to read TikTok first, Pisces. So it says here, timelessness, divine timing, immeasurable time. Love, the fulfillment of desire, and even the body's reproductive cycles have their own timetable. Some things are preordained and cannot be coerced. Everything has its season, its divine and appropriate timing, especially when it comes to the matters of the heart. Remember that you always have enough time for love, to find it, to nurture it, to give and receive. Isn't that wonderful to know? Love is always on the right time. That is amazing, okay? really what is meant to be yours will not pass you by, my dear Pisces. It's only a matter of time. I'm going to read to you regeneration last so we can end this reading. Okay, so it says here, rebirth, second chances, new opportunities. The world is based on connections and relationships. No matter what loss has occurred in the past or even now, death and endings are only illusions. There is life after death, love after loss, and in this moment, you are radiating the regenerative life force energy that makes you irresistible to love in all forms. Now is the time when you will see evidence of this new emergence. Can you feel it? Love is rising up to greet you. Wow, the rebirth is assured, my dear. And hopefully you will make a decision when that time happens. So that is your reading, Pisces. Sending you guys love and light, and I'll talk to you soon.